¿Cómo estáis? Estoy reventadísimo, ¿eh? Uf.
¿Qué tal, compañeros? Buenas noches. Muchas gracias por estar conectados para la rueda de prensa del seleccionador.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this post-match press comments with our coach, Luis Enrique, following the win over Croatia. Please use the UEFA application to ask for your turn to ask a question. Let's begin with the first question. Thank you. Congratulations, first of all. Have you seen such a complete performance from a centre-forward like the one you saw from Morata today? Well, I've been talking about this for months. We're not a team that depends on one particular player to score goals. I don't think there's any coach in the world that wouldn't admire or heap praise on a player like Morata, because he can give you that superiority. He can defend like he was a centre-back. He dominates in the air. He scores goals. He's physically powerful. He's a striker that we should really value because he's very important to the national team. Next question, please. First of all, congratulations on the win, and I'm getting through to the next round. Thinking back to the game back in Wembley, what did you make of that game?
Well, I'm ready
for another tough quarterfinal. I don't know whether my family, friends, and the fans will be able to, but
I think that the
only mistake we committed in this game was the final 10 minutes of the game when we were winning 3-1. I think we should have continued playing the way we had been playing beforehand, and not deciding to go to long balls and play a defensive game, because that's not the game I want to play, even though sometimes it is appropriate. I'm really pleased that we got a second chance and were able to win 5-3, and I think we did play out the end of that game the way we need to, which is playing and defending with the ball. First of all, congratulations on getting through to the quarterfinals. Looking back on the game, everything that happened in it, it was a proper roller coaster, wasn't it? What went wrong in that final 10 minutes of the 90 minutes? And in terms of the quarterfinals, what were you trying to avoid looking forward throughout the tournament? Well, when you're winning 3-1 with 10 minutes to go, it's something you really need to learn from. In terms of the mistake that we made, we didn't manage the ball well, particularly in the free kick ahead of the goal. We needed to prevent the opposition from getting the ball. But of course, we don't have that much international experience within the squad, and perhaps those kinds of mistakes are inevitable. But in terms of the final part of the extra time, that's the way we should have defended throughout and at the end of the 90 minutes, but we're pleased to have got the win. Congratulations. I wanted to ask you about the mistake from Unai Simón and the back pass from Pedri. And what did you make of the reaction from the fans? They were really trying to pick up Unai Simón, and we had the same thing from the the rest of the team.
Fútbol es un juego de errores. No he visto en mi
well, football is about
un
mistakes.
Que errores. Desde los
I haven't
los
seen
los y
any player in my whole career that haven't made a mistake right throughout teams. In terms of Unai Simón, he really put on a show for us today, for everyone. For any kid who wants to grow up and be a footballer, you shouldn't worry about mistakes, you need to be focused on intent. We showed today that after a mistake, of course it was a clear mistake, no hiding that, we picked ourselves up, he made some incredible saves and showed great personality, which is something that we knew to expect from him. So it's a great boost for him and a great lesson for anyone who wants to grow up and be a professional footballer.
Enhorabuena por el pase a cuartos. Cuando te has sentado en la rueda de prensa decías que estabas reventado. ¿Cómo, si tú estás reventado, imagínate cómo están tus jugadores, cómo están de cara al partido de...
How are your players after that game and looking ahead to the quarterfinal match? You said that you were knackered when you got into the press conference room. How are your players?
Cansancio muscular, calambres, lo típico que pasa cuando...
We've seen some cramp today, some muscle tightness. It was a very high-intensity match today, and of course there was a lot of emotional tension, so those things are to be expected. The good thing we have is that any of the 24 players in the squad can start for this team. The confidence and the motivation is never going to change for us, no matter who plays, and that's a great boost for us as we look to kick on and progress through the tournament. I'm sure all the players are going to be fit for the quarterfinals, and then depending on who we are facing, we'll decide who to pick. But I have great assurances from the whole squad. Congratulations, coach. After everything you've won at club level with Barcelona, when you look at everything that's happened over the last week, what importance do you give to this progression through to the quarterfinals? Well, it was a really intense game. And I have experienced some similar ones, but it really had everything today. I think the strange thing is that we got a second chance, and that doesn't usually happen. What really struck me was the final 5 minutes of the extra time. The fans stood up and started applauding, and they were paying tribute to the great effort and commitment of all of the players who had competed. I think that was a lovely gesture from the fans. It's about recognizing the spectacle that both teams put on today. That was a tough game for me on match report duty here because I've had to rewrite a few times. Looking back on the game now, it's not really about what happened, but the emotions that you felt during that game. How did you experience that game on an emotional level? Well, of course, it was a really tough game for me because of the standard of the Croatians. They didn't really create any chances, yet we conceded a goal. So when that happens on the field of play, it's very unfair. And of course, it can lead to a bit of shock for a few minutes. But we reacted, we created chances, and we were able to equalise. After that, we really felt that we could continue to create chances. Obviously, they too had a few moves that could have been dangerous for us, but it went crazy really after the 80th minute. Dani Olmo could have scored the fourth goal to put it to bed, but really that final 10 minutes of the 90 minutes is something we have to learn from, but my squad was capable of doing that within the game. We spoke at half-time in extra time, we spoke about the fact that of course, tiredness was a factor for both teams, but I think the headline is enjoy football. That's it. I'll give it to you.
el campeonato que se hace en la selección, por la entrega que hace cada jugador.
First of all, cada momento de cada congratulations, because that was a fantastic game.
Saltar, celebrar.
You were really getting into it with those celebrations. You were jumping about, really showing your emotions.
Antes del partido estaba súper contento señalando la grada. ¿Qué tienes? ¿Qué piensas? ¿Por qué esa alegría?
Why were you so happy today on the sidelines? Well, because we saw 24 players and 30 or so staff. And of course, everyone always says that it's a family in that kind of situation, but we've really been through everything here within this group. And we've been able to get over those problems. And I think the spirit within this national team is fantastic. We're desperate to do things well. We want to help each other out. We want to improve. So when you're in that kind of group, it's a fantastic feeling. When the word ego disappears and the word team appears, of course, it's fantastic to be part of a group like that. And here we have a team made up of not players, not just players, but also professionals from various different sectors who are proud to represent Spain.
Sí, hola, buenas tardes, señor. Dado el estilo de su equipo y dado el estilo de Francia y de Suiza.
Given the style that your team plays, who would you prefer to play in the quarterfinals, France or Switzerland? I don't have any preference. Of course, France are the reigning world champions. Switzerland are a team that we played against in their Nations League qualifying. They're a good side, but we can't choose who we play. We're going to try to play as well as we have done so far on this team against whoever we play in the quarterfinals. Thank you, everyone.
Lanzaremos el planning de actividades ya en Rusia. Gracias a todos y muy buenas noches.